All right, guys, welcome to the very first fishing live show with CanalGratis.se YouTube channel. I will be your host for today, and my name is Johan Rue, and today we're going perch fishing in the Stockholm archipelago. Before we start, let's make sure everything is up and running and doing well, and let me just quickly walk you through this setup that we have made for you today. So over here you have the main screen, which will be point of view sort of camera. You can follow me, see what I'm doing, tying tackle, stuff like that. Over here we got our main camera. It'll be on your down left corner, where you will get a good overview about what's going on. You can see my rod bands, cool stuff like that. And to your lower right you have the sonar, where you can actually follow what's going on, where we are, and help me spot fish and interesting stuff underneath the boat. So it's sort of a three camera setup, and we're gonna have a lot of fun. During this live session, there will be roughly about 1 hour. You can ask questions. I will do my best to answer them as good as I can. I'm not a super pro, you all know that. We're happy amateurs coming from all the way from Flams to Trams, but I'll try my best to answer your question as good as I can. The goal for this first session is just to make sure that we can actually do this live and have the technique running for an hour or so, and hopefully we will connect with fish. Hope you guys are ready. Let's take it away. Let's go fishing. There we go. Over up here in the front of the boat, I got my Hummingbird Unix set up. Got my little foot pedal going on down there. We got some gear, perch gear, and in a minute we're gonna take a look at all that stuff. But first, let's take the talons offline and move outside. We got this boat sitting here. We're actually in a little dock or harbor here. And we're gonna move outside where it's a little bit deeper, and there might be some fish sitting around these boats here. So we're gonna fish around these spots for starters, and we're gonna work our way like that through the day. And for you guys who's been to CanalGratis Instagram or to our Facebook channel or my personal Facebook channel, you've seen that I posted a map last night with three spots. And this is spot number one that we're fishing. And we're not actually in the mouth of number one, we're further in the inner lake, so to speak. So we got a little bit of heavy wind out there right now. So I wanted to start at a calm area and get everything going, and you know, we'll take it from there. Now, please let me know what you think that I should do, how I should fish, what lures we should use, and all that stuff. This is you guys fishing through me. It'll be sort of like an open source fishing thingy going on. So all systems go, let's go out and catch them. I got this foot pedal, and I'm pretty new to this. Talon's coming offline. Okay, here we go. Just gonna move out a little bit. Lot of fun. Looking good. And as you can already sort of imagine, this is going to be me facing my back against you a lot in this session. So doesn't mean I'm rude, doesn't mean I don't care about you guys, it's just the way it is. In the future, we'll have 10 cameras covering all the angles. But right now, we're gonna have to start with this. So we're coming over here, and I wanna sit. Yeah, you can see on the sonar here, that it's dropping down to 4 meters, like 12 feet. And we're gonna spot lock, I don't know, somewhere around here, I think. This will be a good spot. And I'm using the spot lock on the iPilot. Not a lot of wind, too deep to use the talon. So this will be, you know, our first sort of place. All right, waiting for the spot lock to actually grab onto that position. And I'm using my eyes just to get a feel for the scenario. I did a couple of casts when I arrived on the spot here. I've been out early this morning. I haven't pre-fished any spot really, because I want it to be sort of a fish along format where you and I go out and have fun together, sort of cracking the code for today, for the day. I'm gonna start with a spin rod here. We got lots of weeds sitting on the sides here, but straight ahead we got this boat. So I'm gonna go for a traditional spin rod. We're gonna use the Quantum smoke reel with the Gunki Shigeki rod. And I already tackled up. So here you can see we have the flat nose, mini flat nose by Edwin Johansson sitting right there. And my setup is very simple. I got a fluorocarbon leader attached with a blood knot to a some sort of line, slide braid, Gunki slide braid, 013 I think. And yeah, feel free to ask any questions so I know you're alive, and let's start fishing. Now the first cast of the live show might end up on this huge boat sitting on the deck. It'll be hilarious. Didn't. Just dropping it down close. We want to get as close to this hole as possible because perch will be sitting underneath the boat, I imagine. Imagination is everything. And I want to drop this jig all the way down to the bottom. Sort of trying to get a feel for it. Not going very fast here, going very slow. Trying to get a feel for it. So guys, how are we doing on the sonar? Ooh, bite. Now this is a super sensitive tip. I can feel the slightest movement. So I had a little nibble there. Oh, it's gonna be so much fun. So I'm checking to see if there's any perch following. You guys can do that too. No perch, no perch. Oh. Sorry about that, guys. So perch sitting underneath the boat, obviously. Let's see if we can connect. That would have been great if we caught one on the first cast on the live show, but you know, things aren't that good. Perch fishing is coming on for the season, so to speak. We're coming off the hot water season. Temperature is dropping. I believe we're down to somewhat around 13, 14 degrees. We're in that transit where all the hot water from the bottom is gonna mix up with the hot water, with the water cooling off on top. And you always get a couple of weeks before everything settles in that transit season. And we're right on that right now. So perch haven't really been schooling up like crazy yet. We just have to be patient. We might hit the numbers, but I don't really think so. I think we're gonna hit sporadic fish, you know, one here, one there. Something like that. I would also like to take this opportunity to thank all the guys from the Top Fans Facebook group of Canal Gratis who helped us, did a good job testing out this new format. Thank you. Today, Fabian, we're only gonna fish perch. I think so at least. But you know, if you haven't caught anything for the whole day, I might put on a McRubber and do something crazy. Show you one of my favorite hotspots for pike. There's some really nice spots around here for pike. But you know, it's all about the perch right now, obviously so. And in this live format, you guys can give suggestions on where you want to go to fish. I mean, this is a mobile platform sitting here on the Alumacraft. We can take you guys anywhere where we have cell phone reception, basically. So, you know, anywhere. And it's actually so very mobile that we could take it abroad, you know, go to different countries and do live streams. We put a lot of time and thinking into this, trying to create something really, really useful. How do you like my camera strapped in there? Sitting good back there. I had to strap it in like that because this is a single man show, so to speak. I'm all alone in the boat, so I have to manage everything myself. So it's a little bit tricky not having an operator here, but I'm trying my very best to get it as easy as possible. So we got West Gear Alumacraft online. Welcome to the show, boys. Good to have you. All right, so Peter says he wants me to try the smaller boats behind me, so let's do that, because we're not obviously catching here. Had a little bit of contact, but... Wait a minute, Joje is online. Oh my God. Bro, you should have been out here with me. Can't believe you ditched me, you stood me up. All right, so fishing close to the boats here. See if there's any perch hanging out here. It'll be so wicked. Can't wait for that. We need to get that first fish going, right, guys? Then we can start filling around with gears and, you know, all that stuff. I got tons of stuff to show you. Secret stuff, prototypes, all that good stuff has to come down. All right. We got French people online. Good to have you guys. Good to have you on the show. Fabian, the live show will be roughly 1 hour. We'll see how much fun it is. So I'm landing my bait, just setting it down there really close to the boats, hoping there is perch hanging about in there. So far, nothing. Oof. It's gonna be a little bit awkward till we catch the first fish. I'm actually a little bit nervous. Oh. I know you guys want to get on doing your gardening stuff. It's Sunday, I know, final Sunday before it's winter, all that stuff. But, you know, really, what about that boat, floating boat thing over there? Ooh, wind caught it. Really wicked weather today, but I like it. We got a little bit of wind, provides a little bit of shelter, some roof over the head for the fish. That's good. A little motion and commotion going on. Some of the outer spots in the mouth are hard to fish right now. A lot of wind pushing on the line. If we go there, eventually we're gonna have to use heavier heads. Right now we're gonna stick close to the weeds, see what happens. And I'm just... We got Holland online. Thank you for complimenting my new rod. This rod, I haven't used it a lot, but I have caught some fish on it. And I mean, it is high end all over. All over. Especially, I mean, for me so far, I haven't caught so many fish yet, but what I can say for so long, not for so long, so far, my best feature that I found with this rod is that it's so sensitive combined with this braid. It's ridiculous. Okay, Albin. That's good to know you're fishing with that rod. Maybe you have some more input for me, maybe some tips and tricks for me on how to use it and what setups and rigs I should use with this rod, because I don't really know. You know, I just go out there and fish. I'm not in control of my situation, not of my life. Ooh, it's gonna hit the boat. No, very close. Ooh. Tough. So obviously we started this live show on a spot that we would feel that, you know, we might come in contact with fish like sort of fast, but we're not doing that right now. It's tough in here. So we got a question here about how we can locate fish on a spot like this without the sonar. Well, first of all, you would have to look with your eyes. First feature, look for weeds, bait fish, anything that could give you a hint on where those predators will eat, right? Then when you come to a spot like this, you immediately want to locate the deepest spot, because if they're not up in the weeds trying to eat little minnows and stuff, they might be sitting crouching down at the bottom. Like we're sitting over 4 meters now, and it's there's just no fish here. Kind of gives us the suggestions that we should go out. And if I hadn't had the sonar now, I'd start further in and bounce off the bottom like crazy. Boom, 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 trying to locate. Now the trick is with these shallow bays and stuff in this time of the year is that they can really be on and off like this. Depending on how much wind has been pushing in, cold top water, because that's what it is. I'm using the the Quantum XO baitcaster, and it's a sort of a high speed, a mid speed reel. I think its gear ratio is like I think it's 5-1 on the open spin, and takes in about 72 centimeters of line per strike or per thing. And that's good, especially when you're shorter rods like this. You need to retrieve a lot of line because I don't have a lot of lift. It is a short rod, this one. It's 6-2, I think. I like to use shorter rods. Oi, oi. And on top of this reel, we got a slide braid from Gunky. And it's a very expensive braid. We put it in the Canal Gratis e-commerce. You can go there and check it out. You just click the icon in the top right corner of the screen you're watching. You can go to canalgratis.se web shop. You can check it out. It's an expensive braid. But I kind of get it. I was very skeptical when Pontus Sjölund said that we should get this braid, that it's, you know, the braid. Because I'd say, you know, why would I buy that stupid expensive braid? But now that I'm fishing with it, I understand why you pay those crooners extra, because the contact with the lure is just phenomenal, and the feel that it has to it is just so, the coating is just unbelievable. So it's silent when it shoots through the rings, and I get that extra casting length. It just makes my fishing so smooth. So fancy stuff for you guys who really taking your fishing serious, and you know, might start it off with traditional braid and want to step up. This is not the sort of braid you want to lend out to your friends though. All right guys, we're failing. We're going to start moving a little bit away from this location. See if I can make that happen. Autopilot. Autopilot on constant. All right, we're gonna start moving out of this area slowly. And I'm trying to get my foot pedal skills going here. I suck at this so bad. Okay, you guys keep eyes on the sonar, see if we can contact with, you know, we need to find some bait fish, we need to find active fish somewhere. We're just gonna slide off this spot and move out towards our next spot. We've got weeds now coming up on our left side here. Sometimes you just get lucky fishing close to those weeds. Let's see here. Here, perchy. So the boathouse that we're approaching here, yeah, that's a key spot for sure. A lot of structure down there. A lot of good place for perch to hang out. Also good place for pike to hang out, eating perch. And I'm still not connecting with any weeds here, so that's why I'm still on this rig. I'm not gonna flip over to weedless, go crazy with the Texas rig just yet. I wanna keep working this until I actually have a problem. Casting length is a little bit better with this setup. The bait casting reel is a little bit more tricky to get that full length, but it's much better for accuracy. And I'm not super used, actually, to use the bait casting reel. Emilio is asking where you can buy the rod, and the rod you can find at canalgratis.se, the traditional webpage. You go to canalgratis.se or you click the top right button, it's an icon there, it'll take you straight to the web shop. You can go in there and have a look. Like I said, pretty expensive rod, but it's free shipping worldwide. So, you know, just get in there. Doesn't matter where you are in the world, we'll send it to you for free. The rod's not gonna be free. Shipping will be free. Oh yeah. Sneaky spots this is. I'm close to the weeds in there now, the big weeds. Ooh, I don't want to catch a pike. I don't want it to be a pike. I'm using a, Emilio is asking what jig I'm using. We talked about it earlier, but I'd say it again. It's a flat nose mini or mini flat nose. It's one of the prototypes that Edwin sent me. And since he's part of the Canal Gratis team, I just thought it would be a lot of fun to catch the first live perch on one of his lures. They're not available, you can't buy them anywhere. I don't know if you ever will, but you know. Just a fun thing, I'm guessing. It's a pretty all-around size to it. And Edwin test fished it a lot before sort of releasing it. And he had luck, caught a lot of perch on it. So I'm trusting Edwin. Tough. Perch aren't really in the mood today. Not a lot of action on the sonar here. There's flat bottom following this edge here. Sooner or later, we're gonna find fish. It's important to keep moving days like this. Gotta cover a lot of water. I'm actually gonna speed up the Minn Kota just a little bit. Let's get that stuff in all the way into that boathouse. There's gotta be some perch sitting in there. Got a lot of leaves and stuff on the surface. Good stuff for bait fish. Also suggests that the water is sort of slowing down in there. So, interesting spot for sure. Oi, oi. So we're using a 4G connection here. We're at the Telia, and our stream is 720p. You should be able to get decent quality out there, guys. I hope I'm looking crispy. Yeah, Eric says I should slow down a little bit, and he's right. I'm going way too fast here. Good on you, Eric. You got my back. All right, so Alvin says the perch might be sitting on bottom because it's low air pressure. Interesting. Good pointers there, guys. I like that you're really taking this serious and actually giving me hints. It's correct. It is dropping air pressure, so it might be tricky. I'm gonna drop this all the way down to the bottom, just right out here in the middle. See if we can connect with fish. All the way down, keep my rod up. This is colored green, it's sitting at the bottom now. It's easy for me to see against the black water. And I'm just bouncing it off the bottom. I'm gonna flip you guys over to side imaging so you can really see what's going on the sides here, because we got open water to our right. So let me just finish that cast, making sure we're not doing anything stupid. All right. Oi, oi. Okie dokie. I'm switching you guys over to this view. Gonna speed up the Minn Kota a little bit more. We're going way too slow here. We need to cover water, cover water. And now, since I'm speeding up, I really need to have the back against you, because I want to fish against my lure, so to speak. Going towards it, keeping the line, keeping the lure down. We're not fishing top water today, that's for sure. Yeah, slow moves. I hear you guys. Can tell I'm a little bit nervous. So as you can see the side imaging and stuff now, you can see what I see, and not a lot of action at all on the sides. Scary. This is scary. What if we fail on the first live show and don't catch a fish? Huh? Are you gonna be mad? Let's go slow here, slow here. I'm listening. So this is the jig we're using. This is what it looks like in the water. Look at that. Good movement right there. Yeah, they'll eat that. Sitting on a 10 gram jig, sitting on a 10 gram jig head. I'm gonna speed up a little bit. I'm gonna close up on this weed bed here. This is what it looks like. We're fishing the flat nose currently, and I'm going a little bit too fast on my fishing moves. I got you guys. This is what I like about this format, is you guys correcting me, helping me catch fish, because I suck. Slowing down, slowing down. All right, see if anyone's home here. A lot of depth here, going over almost 5 meters, and we don't have a lot of weeds here. A little bit of weed sitting outside here, but we still will stay on the open spin reel. Just a traditional jig might do the job. I really should have nailed that first fish in there. That's exciting. Ooh, contact. Might have been a small nibble down there. Got some weed sitting at the bottom there. Oops. We're gonna hold up at this position. You guys up for a color change? Let's do it. Let's try something else. Let's go down here and see what we got. You guys talk to me, let me know what you guys want to do. Yeah. This is like the mecca of fishing gear. So much stuff going on here. Go, guys. Here we go. What do you guys want to do? Let me know. Maybe we'll go for a... I don't know, we got the proper perch. These are the only two left in the world. Ran out quickly on these guys. These guys are perch slayers. Might want to use those. You know, we got the ribster. We got, you know, all this cool stuff. What do you guys want to do? Green smaller lure. Green smaller. Let's see here. Let's try green small one, see what happens. I mean, very, very clean, easy setup. Nothing fancy here. See how that looks, guys? Looks fun. Okay, oh, I'm stuck in something. Let's do it. See if they want to eat that little green thing. Oh, would you look at that? So let's put it over where we had a little bit. Oh, there you go, fish on. Good one, guys, good on you. Quick change, downsize when it's slow. I like it, you guys did great. You did that, I didn't do anything. Oh, I like those head shakes. Oh, that's a nice perch. Oh, perch following too. All right, here we go. First perch in the Canal Gratis live show, boys and girls. Wow, look at that. He ate it. He ate it good. Well done. Well done. Well done. So now that we have, I saw fish following, what we want to do is we want to quickly get the hook out of its mouth and we'll just stow it real quickly here in our live well, because we don't want it to pull the school away, and we'll go in there again, same spot. Your technique slowed me down, really slowed me down, downsized, right on the money. That's how you do it. Well done, guys. I love this. This is so much fun. And it ate that lure just, ooh, contact again. Oh, here we go. Ooh, I just felt the first little shake there. It was crazy. The tip is just so sensitive. Good, guys, good, guys. Downsize. I like it. Let's flip this stuff open here. Oh, sorry. Just toss it in there for a while. Okay, guys, let's stay on the spot here, see if we can locate a little bit bigger fish here. Getting greedy already. Getting greedy already. Long drops. And it's fantastic. I got it now. Let's keep. Ooh. Little bite there again, small bite. Sitting at the bottom, someone said earlier, you were so right. These guys are not up. Ooh. They're here. They're actually just following this lure right now. I'm extending my cast a little bit here. They're gonna eat it close to the boat sometimes. See if we have any fish following. Nothing down there. Clean rig. Get it out there again. Let's do our thing. Oops. On the size of the jig head, I couldn't tell. It's a 10 gram short shank, and it's an hang on, I'm gonna have to look at the box. I don't actually remember the sizes. Loads of fun, guys. Are you excited? I'm so excited. Hope you guys are having fun. We're catching them. Let's get that cast in there again. Obviously, this is like stationary fish sitting way in there. Now I'm getting contact with weeds here. This will be a good opportunity for us to switch. Try some Texas Carolina rigging style. See if we can get a bigger fish out of this place. Nope, missed it. Ate right close to the boat. So close to the boat. Okay, we're gonna have to relocate ourselves. We came a little bit too close. I messed up big time. Going out again. Come on. Emilio is asking what my favorite fish is, and I don't know. Today my favorite fish is perch. I mean, I don't have a favorite really. I like all fish, but if I could only choose one, it would have to be pike. Yeah. You guys see that stuff on the sonar? Yeah, we got baits and stuff going on here. Very interesting. Let's lock down here, and let's change to the weedless rig, because I got weed on this constantly now. So we really need to get high in the grass. So I'm tucking this away. These guys are doing okay here. We lost the school thing, so to speak, so I'm just gonna get rid of them. Fun. I know you guys are taking interest in the lucky hat that I'm wearing. And you can click on this top right corner right here and go to canalgratis.se and you can buy that hat. It's a fishing in the middle of Sweden, the official hat. And it's a lot of fun. All right, let's see if we got any rods down here that we could actually use. And we do. Bait caster. Now you're gonna see me get professional over on all that good stuff. Guys, do you want me to stay downsized or should we actually go up a little bit, see if we can connect with a better fish on this rig? Huh? You like that? A little bit bigger stuff going on? I think we should. While you think about that, I'll start casting with this. See what happens. On the bait caster reel. So you guys are also again wondering about my setup for today. This is slide braid from Gunky. It's the most fantastic braid I ever used for this sort of fishing. Actually, it's ridiculous. Look at that. Look at this rig. Yeah, upsizing. We're upsizing. See that stuff? That's what they want. Click, 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 click. Okay. This ribster is really doing the trick. It has a super nice swimming pattern in the water, and it's got a little bit of a thumper tail in the back that gives sense of wave vibration where it goes. I like that a lot. And you can rig it weedless like we do here, that you probably have seen so many times, with an offset hook in various sizes. And you know, when I'm fishing the way we're fishing now, not like pelagical style, I prefer action bait, thumper tails, paddle tails, whatever you want to call them. When I'm fishing more pelagic perch, like really in the bait fish school with small, small minnows, I use non-action jigs. Jigs that doesn't paddle in the tail. And then I work on the side-to-side movements and stuff like that, just to create a different pattern for any potential predator who is looking for a quick snack that is breaking the pattern of the original school, so to speak. We're fishing from the Alumacraft Tournament Pro. It's the it's one of the bigger boats from the Alumacraft family. And Albin wants to know what thickness of the braid I'm using. It's 0.13. Especially when you're fishing weedless rig and you really get in there, you get snagged, you know, man fastnar. So you really need good braid so you can really, you know, push sometimes away from the weeds. All right, let's drop it down there. Good, here we go. Oh, there's a branch hanging above. I'm gonna catch that. That's bad. That's bad. That was bad of me. Lucky for me, I got a weedless rig. All right, so you guys have spotted the rocks here sitting on my right side. So let's do that. Let's get a cast in there. Pretty far away, and I don't want to be messing up too bad on my casting stuff here. I'll get it in there for you. Close enough. Ah. Well. Oh, there we go. Oh, better take. Crap. Still there. I can feel it with this tip. I'm still on a Shigeki rod, and this rod also has that magic tip. Ooh, come on, eat it. I know you want it. I messed up. That was my mistake. My hook set was way off. Might get a second chance. Good call casting on those rocks, bro. Good call. Good call. Let's get in there. All the way in there. We're gonna catch that fish. Is this exciting or is it exciting? Come on. You're supposed to get at least three chances when you're perch fishing. Three? Come on. So now I'm using a little bit more of a side-to-side movement, getting those weights to just bounce off the bottom, just leading that lure through all the weeds. Boat position got pretty messed up. We're coming around, so I'll get a better casting angle right now. Let's do it. There you go. Come on, fish. Now there's a difference here. When I'm not really towards the rock, they don't eat. I really need to get the cast further to the right. I can tell there's a difference. The structure on the bottom is different. One more cast. Good position right now with the boat. There we go. Come on. Perfect cast. Close to the rocks. Come on. There's not a lot of difference between those two rods. They're sort of from the same series. They sort of do the same thing. the guides are positioned a little bit different. They are sitting a little bit higher up on the spin rod, because when it spools off the line, it needs to elevate a little bit more, get up there to spool through the guides perfectly. So the setup, the feel on those two, these two rods is the sort of the same action features to it. The difference is just technical differences to make, you know, because you're fishing off a bait caster or a open spin reel, needs to be a different setup with the guides. And also, of course, it affects the weight and stuff a little bit, but they feel pretty much the same when you're fighting fish. Still got that sensitive stuff going on that you want, especially on a day like this. Come on. Lifting through the weeds here. Cruising through, ooh, contact. Nope. Guys, we should move. There's more spots that we should try out, more stuff I want to show you, so let's get a move on. See if we can go to another place around the corner and connect with some fish over there. So I'm just going to tuck this stuff away and we're going to go for a quick boat ride. It's not going to be long. And if you have questions, I mean, the boat ride is just 2 minutes, but if you have questions, now is a good time. I'm fishing live in the canal, gratis live show segment, and we're having so much fun, and we're gonna catch a big fish today. Paddle. No, I'm not going with the paddle now. We're gonna go regular. All right, hope you guys are ready. As you might already have seen on the plotter, we've been here before. That we have. I'm gonna position myself in a position that I know is quite good, because there's a slope going on to our left here. I wanna fish that slope. So we wanna sit on like 2 or 3 meters of water. I wanna talon down. I'm just using the Minn Kota in the end here because I don't wanna break the props and mess up the crops. Rekvisitan. So closing up on 3 meters here soon. Two. In a minute, guys, we're gonna punch down. We're gonna be ready to fish. Dropping the talons. Boom. All right, so we got some structure over here sitting to our right. We got this dock thing going on. We got a slope over here, deeper ledge that might hold some fish. And we got some weeds to our right here where it's actually going like this, curve down, curve up. And it's a lot of fun. I think that we will begin with a, I need long cast length here, 10 grams of head, and we use that little small bait to see if there's any fish actually on this site. Now I'll try to remember what you guys said slowly, not getting overexcited and stuff. So we're gonna try the boat dock also, but let's start out in the middle and then work our way in. And Johan wonders where we are fishing, and we're actually close to Baggenfjärden in Stockholm archipelago. Farstalandet, Ingarö, places like that. That's where the stuff's happening. I'm going towards you guys here. You can really see me. Oh, fish on. Oh, crap, lost it. And we have weeds. Maybe it was weed. Lost contact there for a while. Got the weeds out. Might still connect with some fish here. Still weeds. Very bad. Very bad. Oops. Still, we want to work this ledge. It's a drop-off. When we leave this spot, we will drive past it, and I will show you on the sonar why we're fishing that magic mark. Because it's dropping off deep, and the fish is sitting there, just waiting for a snack. We got Canada online. What time is it over there? You're 9 hours behind in Canada, and still watching this. That's cool. Cool stuff. It's got to be like 4 o'clock in the morning or something. Very nice to have you on the show. I was in Canada very recently, did a sturgeon show and a collaboration project together with Ankar Angling, Aaron Weeb, and Fishing with Rod YouTube channel. Those videos are about to come online like any day now. We're still working out final grading and stuff like that. Fishing in Canada, Canal Gratis in Canada. It'll be a lot of fun. New viewers coming online here, welcome to the Canal Gratis live show. We're fishing live together with me, Johan Rue. I'm the host for today. And today we're fishing an open spin reel with a 10 gram jig head with a little Lunker City Ripster sitting in the back there, suggested by the Canal Gratis audience. And we're using the Ganki Shigeki spin rod, 6 footer, and an open XO bait caster. Reel, sorry, not XO, it's Quantum stuff. The braid is 013 slide braid. It's a really nice braid. Four a.m. in Canada. He's up early to go fishing. What are you fishing in Canada today? Are you going for pinkies? Or are you going pike fishing? Let me know. I want to hear all about it. Just passing time here. Trying to connect with some fish. Just so impressive how you guys guided me towards that very first cast that we did. You told me to slow down, size down. I need your help. Why are we not catching? What's happening? What's wrong? Why do I suck at this? They shouldn't let me host shows like important shows like this. We should get Joje Wester or Albin Sjargi, somebody good doing this. Obviously it's the first Canal Gratis live show, so I have to be here to technically make sure that it's running. Further into the show, you may request guests. You know, anything can happen in this live show. There we go. Fish on. Yeah. So, someone commented and said fish by the docks, and I very stubborn didn't do that. I fished out where it was deeper, did one cast towards the dock, connected with fish immediately. Good on you guys. You are catching all the fish today. If you have a YouTube channel, let me know. I want to watch that channel and learn how to catch fish, because I suck at this. Not a big school following. We're just going to toss it off over the side, keep working the fish over there. Close up on the docks, on those pillars. This will be a lot of fun. There's so much weed in there. We need to go weedless. Now will be a good time to bring out the bait caster and go weedless. Perfect spot for that, because I'm sitting in weed constantly here. Might get a bite, but all that weed sitting on my jig is gonna mess it up. So I'm not getting the maximum presentation time here. And I'm definitely single out big fish. They're picky. Feed. So guys, we have been going on for like almost an hour. Can't believe you guys are still watching, and I hope you're having fun. An hour is sort of the preferred length of a live show, I think. But since this is the first one, we might just roll with it. It's up to you guys. Let's call it a vote. You want to go past 1 hour? We can go for a longer boat ride across the Baggenfjärden, and we can try out a really different spot and see if it holds any, you know, like bigger fish. It's up to you. I got all day, so, you know, let me know what you're thinking. You guys want to stop? Want to go out fishing yourself? Feel free. Let me know. Underneath the dock, suggested here by Mikael. And let's actually do that. That's a very good suggestion. Let's change our position a little bit here. See if we can make a difference. Before, I just want to do one more cast. And why I want to do that is I want to get a feel for where the grass is. All the way down there. Seems like you guys want this to be a longer segment. I'm up for it. Got a lot of fuel in the boat. I mean, we will have live segments later when we have the technique figured out. We actually go fishing for a whole day. It's gonna be crazy. Talons up. Minn Kota speed down a little bit. Let's sneak over there and see if we can fill that bait in there. You guys just want to see me mess up and get stuck. You should quit while you're ahead. I should quit right now. We should sort of go offline now and say bye-bye. You know, when I'm on top of things. But we're greedy. We're anglers. We want to catch. We never stop fishing, do we? You see how I'm sucking at driving the boat with this foot pedal? Feel free to, you know, comment on that. That's, I know, I need to hear it. Talons down. Gotta love those talons. Can't live without my talons. Ooh, almost got an overrun there. Oops, just hit a buoy with my rod tip. That's gonna break for sure. Gotta be really careful when you're handling these sensitive tips. Don't let them stand out like I just did. That's bad. We got a huge rod compartment down there. Rods should be in there when you're not using them, if you're not sort of fishing a tournament or something. Very stupid of me. All the way down there. Come on, Lur. All the way down there. Alexander wants me to go for a slower retrieve and more natural color. Well, I think this is quite natural, I would say. I'll go for the slower retrieve, see what happens. I mean, obviously there is fish sitting underneath this dock, but seems to be small fish and they don't want to prey on this big Lunker City stuff. And I'm having really a little bit of problem with my accuracy getting stuff in there. I don't want to get snagged in there today with you guys watching me from all over the world, making a complete fool out of myself. So just work our way careful and then go closer, taking more risks later on. Really gotta get that beat going. Boom, boom. Weeds and shit. Let's do a long cast. All the way in there. Perfect cast, perfect cast. Should catch. Contact. Contact. Oh, crap. I can see you guys cheering for a little bit of black color in here. I don't think I have that in my tackle box, really. Good cast again, should deliver some fish. Lift. Yep. Lift and drop. So, yeah. Lift and drop, lift and drop. I just realized you guys lost your point of view field there, so I'm just gonna fix that real quick. A bit of technical difficulties going on here. Nothing to be too worried about. Hope you guys soon will get the GoPro camera back online. I just lost it there for a while. So right now you guys should be good. We should be back online. We'll take this time to switch swap spots again. Alrighty. Everything is up. Hope you guys can hear me, hope you guys can see me, hope everything is fun. You're watching the Canal Gratis live show, we're back online, and we're moving. We're going to another spot, see what happens. Thank you guys for helping me catch fish. You're very good at this, I'm not. Obviously, we've been going on for an hour. Welcome all new people joining us. Make sure the talons are up. We're ready. Let's quickly move. Another cool location, just around the corner. Hang tight. Yeehaw! This is the best part. Let's see what we got here. We're gonna slow troll with the Minn Kota here, going against the current for a little bit. We're gonna use weedless rig. We're gonna stay with this one. Might have to downsize a little bit, but this is how we're gonna do it for starters. Hope you guys are still with me. Hope you're having fun. My name is Johan Rue, and you're watching the Canal Gratis live show where we're out perch fishing with you guys. So let's sneak up on this spot. This is a very weedy spot, and we're actually at the mouth of the this place. So we got a lot of current pushing through, and it actually stops in this position. I should switch also, so you guys can see more accurate what I'm doing. Here we go. Loads of fun. Here we go. So you guys are asking how long this rod is. It's, I think it's 6'2", around 195 centimeters long. Pretty short rod, perfect for the boat. Slow down, you guys just told me. Working our way. Ooh, see that stuff on the bottom there, guys? See that stuff? See that stuff we just passed slowly there? Wow, I don't know what that was. We passed it sort of slowly, so wasn't a super big, wasn't the fish wasn't that big that it sort of seemed like, but look, might be sander. It looks like there were two echoes down there. Sander likes to appear like that. Maybe not this time of the season.
Etvo.
Should be good. Hope you guys can hear me all right. Let me know if you can't. I don't have anything super interesting to say, but you know, just some sound would be nice. We're doing this fishing show after all. Things need to run smooth. We're fishing slow, suggested by the Canal Gratis audience. We'll try if we can locate some fish. We're going all over the place. We're fishing spot one. Last night we posted a couple of screenshots of the spots that we plan to fish this day. You can go into our Canal Gratis Instagram channel. You can go into our Facebook channel and check them out. We're at spot one. We're fishing in the weeds, weedless, with a bait caster. We're trying out different ways to catch perch today. I'm getting a lot of good tips from you guys on how to slow down my fishing, not going too fast and get overexcited about stuff, and how we really can work our way through this day and catch fish. My name is Johan Ruwe and this is the Canal Gratis live show, and you can subscribe to canalgratis.se. We post fishing videos on a regular basis, uploads roughly about 2 shows every week, have been doing so for a long time, and we have a lot of pike sessions, trout sessions, sturgeon sessions, collaborations from all over the world. All right, requested by Canal Gratis audience right now, fishing that spot, the little open spot there by the weeds. Let's go over there and try that. Let's just not get all tangled up. Let's see, talons are where. I just want to say to you, so you know, this one is live stream. We're sending through the internet right now. Uh-huh. Is it okay for you?
Yeah, that's okay.
No problem.
No.
You guys catch anything fun?
No, we just came.
You just came?
Yes.
What are you fishing for?
Perches.
Perch?
Yes.
Yeah, me too. I might just want to think about that because I'm not doing so very well.
Okay.
Have you caught anything here recently?